Can we grab you really quick? First of all, how are you feeling today? Man, you're looking skinny today, dude. You're ready to fight.
It's called being in shape.
Let me rephrase that.
The difference between being skinny and being in shape.
That's true.
But you're used to seeing 20, 30 pounds overweight in between fights. We don't roll like that, man.
Andre, first of all, tell us what you thought about that fight in there, man. Give us your breakdown of what happened.
It was a good fight. I was hoping that Stavern maybe, you know, let his hands go in spots, you know, a little bit more. I think it could have been competitive. I think he could have had more action, but he didn't, and maybe it was a reason for that. Maybe that was Wilder's power. I don't know, but you got to take your hat out to Wilder. It was a great, great fight.
Do you think all the questions were answered tonight about Wilder, or are there still questions lingering? I mean, there was a lot riding on this fight for him.
I mean, I don't think you can answer all the questions in one fight, but, I mean, he showed he can go the distance. You know, he took the title from a champion, so he gained a lot of respect just from how he went about his business tonight. You got to respect him for that. He's the heavyweight champion of the world.
Go to you, Rock Nation, man. How excited are you? I saw the show, man. I was at home pumped up. How is it being with Rock Nation, with Jay-Z, and that kind of, you know, you're pioneering that?
Man, come here, Jay. It's a big deal, man. And, you know, Jay, my manager, man, he orchestrated everything. And, you know, he brought it to me at the right time and said, man, you know, we need to look at this. We sat down and looked at it. We had a meeting, and this was the right deal, man. This is what was right for my career. I can't speak for anybody else, but at this stage of my career, that's what we needed. And I'm happy to be a part of Rock Nation Sports.
What's your favorite Jay-Z song?
Man, I don't know, man.
You got a lot.
I don't know.
Everybody knows you're one of the best fighters in the world. Who would you want?
Man, it's simple, guys. It's like, you know, being in the position that I'm at, I shouldn't have to call names out. I shouldn't have to chase guys. I shouldn't have to do any of that stuff. They should really be, like, gunning for me. Everybody in the top 10 should be gunning for me. And why they're not, I don't know. You know, so it may be a situation where we've been calling out the Golovkins and the Frotches and you know, these guys that say they want to fight, but when it's time to really talk about it, they don't bring my name up, and they think because we don't respond to a lot of the stuff they say in the media that they act like we can't poke holes in the stuff that they say. It's a lot of excuses. And people, if they know me, man, I'm real black and white. I don't play a lot of games in the gray area. We should fight each other. If we say we're warriors and all of this, we should fight each other. If we say we want to give the fans what they want to see, we got to step up and fight, man, and let the best man win. I'm not invincible. Anything can happen in a boxing ring. But I'm willing to put my record, and I'm willing to put my reputation on the line against anybody.
We're here at the MGM, May 2nd, Mayweather Pacquiao. Everybody, all the signs, all the indication.
I didn't say it.
What did you say?
Tell him Triple G don't want her.
You said it. I ain't said it.
160 to 154. He was saying 168 2 years ago.
Now he don't want me. If I say it, they don't get mad at me.
SOG, tell him. Tell him SOG. He don't want her.
Talk to about Golovkin. What do you think about that fight? What do you think of Golovkin? Everybody keeps mentioning that name to you. What are your thoughts on him and the possibility that fight actually happening?
I don't know about, I can't speak on the possibilities, but some people, you know, they ask me if he's a hype job, and I think absolutely not. I think that, you know, anybody that becomes a silver medalist, anybody that comes out of the amateur system that he came out of, you know, you don't get that far not being a real deal. So I think he's the real deal in terms of his pedigree. But I do think that, you know, he gets a lot of passes in the media at this stage in his career without having fought the best. It's as simple as that. And other guys wouldn't get that. I mean, they're still talking about Floyd ducking people. And he's been on top since the 90s. And sometimes guys have the audacity to say that Floyd is ducking this guy, ducking that guy, when this guy has a resume.
We represent over here.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So sometimes from that standpoint, it's extra hype from that standpoint. When you start, you know, hailing the guys this and that without having a resume, it's tough to do that, man. That's for me. That's for him. That's for anybody. I think for any of us to get to the Hall of Fame or even be called great, I don't think any of us are great right now. There's only a handful of great fighters in the sport that are active. Bernard, Floyd, you know, Antonio Tarver, guys that have been doing this. None of us have done anything to be great. So you got to look at the resume, and I think he's got to get the resume in order to get some of the accolades that he's been getting. But as far as his pedigree, I think he's got that for sure. And I think a fight with me and him would be a great fight.
Can you put on the commentator half a second? Because you're one of the best at doing that. And you and Paulie, I like to listen to most. Mayweather Pacquiao, how does Andre Ward break it down? Let's say it's happening.
I'm definitely going with Floyd. That's my guy. You know, I think with Manny's volume, I think that's something that it's going to take Floyd probably 3 or 4 rounds to get used to the type of punches that Manny throws. And Manny's going to have some moments in the early round, but I think Floyd, what separates him from the best is the adjustments he can make on the fly, his IQ and his overall boxing IQ, but then the way he processes things when everything is going on. So I think he's going to make the adjustments, and I think he will pull away mid to late in that fight.
Amir Khan, him against Pacquiao, exciting fight?
I think so. I think any fight that Amir is in is going to be exciting.
How do you think he would do?
That's how I feel about it. I don't know. I mean, that's a good fight. I think that's a 50-50 fight. I think whoever has the best game plan, and I think whoever executes the game plan, I think that that's going to win the fight. But that's a 50-50 fight, in my opinion.
Andre, do you stay at 168, or do you move 175? A lot of people get throwing Kovalev out there. Do you feel you still have a lot of stuff to do at 168, or would you be open to going up?
I mean, I'm just trying to listen to my body. You know, I'm my weight is right. I'm not, you know, I don't blow up in between fights, you know, and I stay disciplined in between fights. So I'm a super middleweight right now, and I think that, you know, when I become a light heavyweight, a full fledged light heavyweight, I don't have a problem fighting any of those guys. You know, and I got a lot of respect for Kovalev because he's doing it right. You know, he's putting everything on the line to fight the best, fight in and fight out. He believes in himself to that degree, and I got nothing but respect for that.
What do you tell your fans, people who support you, who couldn't wait to see you get back
Thank
in there?
You. Thank you.
What do you tell them if they're watching?
Man, they showed the patience of Joe, man. It's been a long, long battle, but you know. I've been fortunate because what I've noticed was, like, you know, sometimes in a situation where you're not on the scene, your stock can drop, people forget about you. But I've seen it actually rise, and it's been such a, you know, just an excitement about me coming back that I think it even got bigger, as crazy as that sounds. So I just want to come back and thank them by picking up where I left off. That's what I want to do. I'm so thankful for all the fans and even the negative press. You gotta have that element, man, to keep you humble, keep you right, get you out the house when you don't want to leave the house some days to go work out. I appreciate them too.
Who do you think gets the most hate online from fighters?
I don't know, because I don't really read a lot of stuff online, man. I have people on my team that read it and keep me abreast, but I don't read it. When I was a young fighter, I used to be on every website, man. I can't do it, man.
Okay, Broner Molina. Exciting fight.
Good fight. Good fight. I like Molina. I like Broner. Broner's going to come with a lot of speed and you know, a lot of toughness. And Molina's not backing down from nobody. I'm excited about that one.
Okay, Thurman Guerrero.
Oh, man, that's another good fight. You know, got a lot of respect for Thurman. Guerrero's my boy, man. We come from the same place, so I'm always riding with him, man. But that's, like, that fight is another fight where I'm going to watch it. So I'm a boxing fan.
Andre, they consider you still number 2 pound for pound, and even though you've been out of the ring for about a year. If you come back, people already want you to go with the big names, but do we have to be realistic and expect a gradual kind of...
I mean, I think that's in order. I think that's in order, being that, you know, I've had 2 fights in 3 years. They don't like giving me tune-up fights for some reason. Last tune-up I had was 2009, right before the Kessler fight against Shelby Putnam. That's the last fight that you can consider a tune-up. But it comes with your territory, man. I think fighting all those tough fights back-to-back like that, was fortunate to not take any major punishment and put on exciting fights and also learned a lot. Each fight that I fought, you know, I went to another level when I fought Frosch, and then when I fought Chad Dawson, I went to another level. So each fight, man, it really teaches you something. It takes you to another level. So I'm thankful.
Big night in boxing history tonight. Muhammad Ali turned 73. Yes. You're the type of person that always pays homage to the originals. Yes. What do you wish Muhammad Ali, and have you ever met him? What's your best moment with him?
Man, that's probably one of the only greats that I haven't met.
Wow.
Never met.
Really?
And I hope to meet him one day. I can't say enough about Ali. I'm glad he's feeling better. I'm glad he's back at home. We went to the hospital for a little while, but it's a guy that we grew up on, man. It's a guy that we emulated, still emulate, still watch. 60s and 70s and 50s, when he just transcended the sport of boxing, and we're still talking about it today in 2014. To me, he's the greatest ever. Not just because of what he did in the ring, but he took the risk, you know, how he fought those fights, even in his losing efforts, and then just how he transcended the sport. The things he did back in those days was unheard of. It was unheard of.
My last question for me. Everybody tells me that Andre Ward beats anyone at 68 or 75. Why do everyone keep telling me that?
I mean, I appreciate that, but I don't look at it like that, because I know sometimes these fights look easy, man. They're not easy. But even the Edwin Rodriguez fight, like, it looked, it's not easy. You know, I was a big guy that night, 192 pounds, and he's throwing hard. And It's not easy, man. I'm blessed, man. I'm fortunate. But all I got to do is keep. I can't listen too much to the praise. I can't listen too much to the criticism. I got to try to stay in the middle, man. And that's where success has been for me. That's where I find my blessings at, and where God blesses me is when I don't get too caught up in that. But I'm thankful that they say that, man. But I got to, each fight, I got to prove them right.
Thank you.
My last question. While you were out, I know you always keep tabs on the sport. Who are some of the fighters today that you kind of enjoy watching?
Man, I love a lot of fighters. I like watching Broner. I like watching Molina. I like watching Guerrero, Thurman, Berto. Hadley, young fighter that's not on TV a lot, but he fights a lot in Texas. I think he's going to start being shown a lot. Pascal, I'm excited about the Pascal and Kovalev fight. I mean, I like the young guys coming up that nobody knows, the guys mid-level, the club fighters. Like, I respect it all. I can come to a big fight, man, and watch the first fight to the last. I just love the sport. I'm a big fan.
Absolutely. Thank you, Andre, man. Good luck. Can't wait to see you back in the ring.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Stay tuned. VisionReport.com. Release it back reporting.